Now, what we're going to do is to step back, or actually step forward. We're going to zoom out and take a look at the bigger picture because I want everything to be able to fit in context of what we're doing. Again, it's like in Men in Black, right? When it zooms out at the end, spoiler alert, by the way, and you see that the galaxy is actually on a let's see, there was a galaxy on the dog's collar, but what was the, oh, we were marbles, that's right. It zooms out in the galaxy and everything, and then we're marbles, I believe, that are being played by some big aliens. Wow, I'm stretching here, I know. Okay, anyway, we're going to zoom out and take a look at the big picture and then see how everything fits in context. Because what I'm going to do is this. I've decided, you know what, I really like my power method that I wrote. And furthermore, I kind of like that, if I go back to my method fun Java class, I like that square method that I wrote. And I think that they might be useful not only in this program, but in other programs. So what I'm going to do is this. I am going to create a separate class to hold these variables. Now again, we're going to talk about classes and object-oriented programming in future lectures, but I want to get this idea across. I'm going to create a public class and call it Useful Math. Okay, that's going to be the name of the class that I'm creating that's going to house these cool methods that I've written. So I'll go first and pull my square method, and I'm going to copy that and then paste it into this method or into this class, and that'll be one method of the Useful Math class. Okay, it can square. The only change we'll want to make is we won't want to have it be static anymore because static means that it belongs to the class itself, and when we're using objects, we don't want the method to belong to the class, we want it to belong to the object. This is, again, don't get too caught up in this. I'm just trying to zoom out for a minute. Men in Black style. Okay, so I'm going to take out that static keyword. Same thing in the more method fun. I'm going to go pull my really cool power method that I wrote. And I'm going to put that in my Useful Math class as well. I probably really ought to have some comments in here. I'm setting a horrible example. But now I've got two methods. I've got the square method and I've got the power method. Again, I want to get rid of the static keyword in this Useful Math class. So I'll save this class and now it's saved. Now notice there's no main method in this class. These are just methods that we're able to use. But what I can do is this. In my Method Fun class, I'm going to get rid of that. Let me close the method fun actually. Let me go back to my more method fun. So in the more method fun, I'm going to get rid of the power method because it doesn't, I've got it stored somewhere else now in another class. But in this main method, I can now, to access that same class, where is it located? Well, it's now located in the Useful Math class. Now, I have to have that Useful Math class saved in the same directory if it's not in the system directory. But if it's saved in the same directory, then I can create an instance of it just like we do with the scanners or with the randoms. I can say, I want to build a Useful Math class in this program. In my more method fun program, I want to create a Useful Math instance that I'll just call and that'll be a new Useful Math instance, and then I have to have an opening and closing parenthesis there. We'll talk more about that later on as well. So I've got my Useful Math class now, and now if I want to call that same power method, who does it belong to? Well, it belongs to the UM that I just created. And so I need to say system.out.println, and I can say, if I try to say power 2 to the fifth, like we were just doing, I'm going to get an error saying, I got no clue what you're talking about. Cannot find that symbol power. that means nothing to me because there's no power inside this particular class. Okay, well, where is the power method? It's in the useful math, right? And so I can say, instead of calling the power method, I'm going to call the um.power method. The um is the class. The dot power is the method that belongs to that class that's going to do something. So now if I compile and run this program, I'm going to get that result of 32. Well, what's happening? It's calling the useful math class, creating an instance of it for me to use, just like we do with the scanner, just like we do with the random. And now I'm going to call that instance and say, I want to access the power method, and here's the information that's required in order to access that method. The pow is it's a num and a pow that we're passing in. Okay, so there's the num, there's the pow. And so I pass that information in, I get a result out. I could do the same thing with the square. I could say system.out.println .power. Oh, we don't want to call power, we want to call square. Square, and then pass in a 12. And I should get printed out the 32 that I got printed out before, and then a 144, right? Isn't that 12 squared? Missed a parenthesis. I'm no better than you. Okay. And then I get the 144 that I was looking for. Those methods belong to the useful math class, but they're methods inside the class. Now, where am I going with all this? My point is this. When we create an instance of a scanner, the scanner in equals new scanner system.in. We've created an instance of that, and in order to do that, we need to import the java.util.scanner method. We build an instance of that, and then we say system.out.println, which number would you like to square? Well, I probably need to create an integer here called number. I'll just call it num. And set it equal to 0 to begin with. Well, then I'm going to read in that by saying in.nextInt. Okay? And we're going to set the num equal to in.nextInt. So now picture what's happening. Somewhere out there, just like we've written our own useful math class, somebody has written, or a team of people have written, a scanner class. And just like the useful math has a power method and a square method, if we look at it, there's the power method, there's the square method, they're both having information passed in, doing something and returning something. Just like useful math has those two methods, the scanner has a method called nextInt. And if we went out and looked at the code would be going out to the console and reading in the characters and assembling them as an integer and then passing you back an integer, which we're then catching and setting equal to the num. So this is just a method out in another class, exactly the same as this is just a method out in another class. Okay, are we getting kind of the big picture? Now I want to do this, and I hesitate because we haven't really talked about classes and objects and all that kind of stuff in great detail. But where we're going next is to talk about methods that have already been created, pre-built methods in Java. The nextInt is a pre-built method. We don't see how it does what it does. All we know is we call it, it gives us the integer we want out of the buffer, and then we can use that. That's all we know, that's all we care about. Okay. So to just maybe wrap this up, I didn't have to go and write the power method, because there's already one built and out there. Okay, I can get rid of all this, because built into Java there is a math class, and that math class has a pow method. So if I say system.out.println and I print math, that's the name of the class, dot pow, and then pass it two numbers, 2 and 5, and compile and run this program, I get a 32. Alright? That is a method in a class that's already been defined. Now, in this case, I didn't need to create an instance of it. But there is a math class sitting out there with a pow method where I pass in a 2 and a 5, and it probably is doing exactly the same thing that we're doing with a for loop, but it's a pre-built method in Java that makes life easier for us, because we can just call that method. And it gives us the result that we want to. Now, it's giving us the result as a double, you can see. And that's probably good, because then I could take 2.5 to the fifth power and see what that comes out to be, and I get the result as a double. And so when they've defined it on their end, instead of an int num, they have double num to get that information. All right? So we kind of zoomed out, now we're zooming back in. We can use these pre-built methods for our benefit, but that's how a method works. And if we're writing programs well, we should try to break them out into methods that make sense. Whenever we can break out into a method, it's a good idea, generally speaking, to break out into a method to kind of keep the program compartmentalized in the things that it does. Okay, so that was a huge introduction to methods, but hopefully it makes sense. Hopefully you're getting a feel for how methods are used in programming, and what we'll do next is kind of take a look at how we're actually going to use those. Okay? Spencer, out.